I bought a Logitech K15 keyboard for the office a while back. Needed a keyboard, any keyboard to type on. For general typing purpose, it worked well, but after 2 years, it was no longer as smooth. So as an upgrade keyboard, I bought the MK345. It's a mouse keyboard combo for about $25, and these are wireless. Plenty on offer for the price. Let's see how they go. So let's start the unboxing. Once we open the box, we have the keyboard and the mouse presented, and in the corner we have the USB receiver. Now, this is not a unifying receiver, but more on that in a moment. I really appreciate the fact that all the batteries were included. Just pull out the tabs and we are ready to go. On that note, Logitech is claiming 4 years battery life for the keyboard and 18 months for the mouse. With a bit of wiggle room, I would mostly agree to those timeframes, because my experience with other Logitech products that I've reviewed in the past, times and times over, their battery stamina has been proven. In other words, Logitech has earned their reputation for having nice long battery life. So let's look at the keyboard. It has a permanent wrist rest. Being part of the keyboard, it is nice and rigid structure, as opposed to other keyboards that has a bit of a movement because the wrist rest is a separate piece. Issue is that those who do not want it cannot detach it. The entire keyboard is pretty much plastic. There is no rubber surface to touch. Same goes for the mouse as well. It is all hard plastic construction. Having said that, the quality and finish of the keyboard and the mouse is free from any imperfection. What I mean is, to lower the price tag, they used material that is economical, but it does not feel like it's something cheap. The keyboard features a standard layout, which is an important consideration. I'll explain why in a moment. There are function keys that can be used for media control and so forth, which is nice and handy. The mouse, as mentioned, is fully plastic, but functional, with the usual left and right click, a nice wide scroll wheel that has good feedback for each line of scrolling. Other than that, there is really not much else to say. It is just a basic mouse. Back to the keyboard. As mentioned, this keyboard is intended to replace an office keyboard. Clearly, this is not gaming suitable keyboard, so that question is done for straight away. Typing, and lots of it, is going to be the bread and butter of this keyboard. And to that end, I believe Logitech has played it safe. The layout is standard NC-104 keys layout. Standard is important for those who type a lot, can rely on their muscle memory. The keys bounce back nice and fast, and has good feel when pressing. If I'm being picky, the key height is lower than what is considered standard. The feel factor overall does not reflect the lower price tag. So, the core deliverable, the job of a typing instrument, this keyboard is successful. There is an issue, however. The wireless receiver that was supplied in the box is the only one that can be used with this set of keyboard and mouse, meaning I am using a unifying receiver for my Logitech 720 mouse, and I attempted to pair that receiver with the keyboard and wanted to use the mouse on another computer. That cannot be done. While this is not a deal breaker for many, at least for me, I could have used the mouse, but it will go into storage somewhere without use. That is a waste. I'm not happy about it. So in conclusion, the keyboard is wireless. It types well, it is built well, it had a simple job description, and it does it. The mouse is the most basic wireless mouse there can be, with no extra feature, yet functional for day-to-day use. Most average office computers needs no more than what's on offer. Hence, being simple and functional while being economical is its success. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. On a side note, I have a Echo NXT acoustic guitar to give away to one of my viewers. If anyone lives in Sydney and would like a guitar, please get in touch with me. Yeah, I just bought another one on a whim. Anywho, I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.